recognize Future, Sally Wilson.
Yep. They recognize when you ain't done now.
Sitting inside the trenches with my nigga, he on house arrest. All right, let's do it again. Sitting inside the trenches with my nigga, he on house arrest. Keep that.
Katy Perry, yeah, serving Katy Perry, yeah. I should off, yeah. I should break it off, yeah. Break it off, yeah. Made myself a boss, yeah. Let's fuck out some commas. Let's fuck out some commas, yeah. Let's fuck out some commas. Let's fuck out some commas, yeah. 500,000 to 100,000. 100,000 on 100,000. 300,000, 500,000. $1 million, have money shot.
I wanted the average person to feel like they want to fuck out some commas.
Yeah. Even if their pay scale's not there, the feeling.
You feel like it's just a motivation or something.
Yeah.
It make you feel like you got a chance to do it. I'm like, this song gonna make you feel like if you don't have commas, when you listen to this song, you're gonna feel like you fucked up some commas and it couldn't be a few hundred. You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
That's what records are about. It's about feeling. It's the feeling it give you. No matter if you rich or you poor, when you hear this song, you're gonna say fuck up some commas. No matter if you rich or you poor, when you hear New Bugatti, you're gonna say you woke up in a New Bugatti.
Yeah.
You can walk, you can never own a car in your life, and you gonna say this line because it's about feeling.
And I knew commas from the beginning. Well, I could have just said, okay, I'm gonna just drop commas and don't even drop months. I'm gonna just drop one single and just drop commas. But I knew I had to give them a complete body of work at that time because my presence wasn't felt as much. Even though I had dropped Move That Dope in 2014, I had dropped Hold You Down, and they both was number one records on the urban side of the charts. I always had a record on the charts ever since I done came out. I've dropped the number one every year, ever since fucking 2010, 2011. I've dropped the number one record, 2011, 2012, 2013, 2014, 2015. I got some shit on the radio. I wasn't as consistent last year, but I still made number one records. I still dropped two number one records, put an album out, was getting X amount of dollars for a show, and I was good. Was getting engaged and all kind of shit and just spending hella money, whatever, whatever, living life. But at the end of the day, man, I know what make me happy is making music. None of that amounted to me being happy. None of me living in LA, me having cars, and none of that shit amounted to me making music. That's when I know my passion. I was over-passionate for the music. And I had to show it. I had to show what made me different, you know what I'm saying? And I had to drop a whole body of music like Monster. From the beginning to end, and only had one feature with Wayne.
That's the thing with you too. Like you put a lot of material out, feeding the fans, putting it out for free. You know, the label must not love that. Like, how do you keep that relationship where it needs to be? Meanwhile, you're putting out these quality album level projects, but you're giving it to the public for free.
Man, it was just like it was needed. It was much needed. I was in a show and prove situation.
Each tape give you a different feeling. Like, I know music, I've studied the game. I'm not telling you this, I'm showing you this shit. I just dropped Monster Beast Mode and 56 Nights and I ain't got no features. And y'all love this shit, like, I'm showing you this shit. I ain't gonna tell you this shit. It ain't up for debate. I love zero room for a debate. You could debate me after Dirty Sprite said, man, nigga dropped the classic, Screech Calling, man, he had all those fucking hits. He wrote songs for this and that, R&B songs. But what about now? He came and he got, there was a time for him. I came back and dropped nothing but street records after I done dropped number one records. Came back with the mixtapes and gave away free. After I had achieved a certain amount of success in the industry and being a superstar in the game, or so to speak, whatever, whatever. You know what I'm saying? To come back to my essence, to the core of my core fans, and deliver something that they can accept and live with and feel great about and accept me as one of their own. Like I never left.
I stir the face. You a fucking rich nigga for the fame, won't you? You'll get that pussy up to a lane, won't you? Like an old school, I redid the frame on you. I got my old shooters with me and they land on you. Bird to them niggas at the six. A whole lot of lean, my nutrition. They should've told you I had them drink coming. They should've told you I brought a bank with me. They should've told you I keep that Miley on me. They should've told you I got that stick with me. You the one who ducking from a drive-by. My niggas unemployed selling pie pies. I serve the bass, I serve the bass.
I serve the base, I serve the base. I keep a shooter with me like Malone. I fuck around and did it on my own. Coming forward with me, baby, I'm a